Hello everyone, this is Jean from WP Mayor. In this review, we'll be taking a look at the Rublon Invisible Two-Factor Authentication plugin for WordPress. Right now, as you can see, I'm on the Rublon.com website, which explains the process of how this plugin works. Now, this plugin is available for free from the WordPress.org plugin repository, and you just come here basically to learn about what the plugin does. Following that, you just need to install, number one, the plugin on your WordPress website. And secondly, you need also to install the app, the mobile app, which is available for Android, for iOS, for BlackBerry, and even for Windows Mobile OS. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how Rublon protects you from hackers. This is the traditional way that we log in. So this guy, Adam, signs in with a password only or username and password. This is inherently quite unsafe because obviously if somebody can get a hold of your username and password, he can sign up into your online service from anywhere in the world using any device. So Rublon attempts to add an extra layer of security in that procedure. Here's how Rublon works. Adam secures his account with Rublon, then confirms his identity using the Rublon app and adds his laptop to his trusted devices. You can have mobile devices, you can have desktop PCs, you can have laptops, you can have any device that connects to the internet in your trusted devices list. So, what happens next? Adam still signs in with his username and password, but his account is now secured by Rublon. Now, the bad hacker will try to log in into Adam's account using another device, a device which is not in the trusted devices list of Adam. So what happens? Rublon will block the hacker. And that's basically how Rublon protects you in a very transparent way. That's why we said in the beginning that Rublon is an invisible two-factor authentication. Competitors of Rublon make the same two-factor authentication procedures, but are not really invisible. They add an extra layer even for the user. I think you get the idea how Rublon works. So the next thing is to get started and install the Rublon plugin on our test installation. I'm going to get Rublon from the WordPress.org repository, as I mentioned earlier, and I'm also going to go ahead and download the Rublon app on my mobile phone, which happens to be a Samsung S2 using Android. For those on iPhones, there's of course also the app for iPhone. All right, so I've installed the mobile app, the Rublon app on my mobile device, and I'm also trying to log in into the Rublon.com account. So the first thing that happened when I installed the app on my mobile is that it asked me for an email address, and I received an email to confirm and set up my account. Upon clicking on that link, I am presented with this screen, and what I'm doing right now is using my mobile device to point this at the screen. And we can see on my mobile device, you cannot see it, I've got an action confirmed confirmation, and we've logged into my device. So I just logged in using my mobile device, scanning that QR code that was on the previous screen. From this screen, which is my Rublon control panel, I can add email addresses and I can also control my protected accounts, which are listed right here. So we're back into our WordPress installation, where I'm going to go ahead and install Rublon. Rublon, as you can see, is showing us the Protect Your Account button immediately, and of course also telling us that we need to download the free mobile app, which we have already done. Are you ready to protect your account? Here we go. I'm going to click on the Protect Your Account button, which will take me to the Rublon account on Rublon.com. And here's where I'm using my mobile device again to scan the QR code. I've got a question on my mobile device, which says, do you trust this device? I'm going to select yes. Screenshots of my mobile device are available on the full review on WPMayor.com. And since the answer was yes, my account is now protected by Rublon, and it can be accessed from your trusted devices list, which I showed you earlier. So that's practically it. When I go to log in the next time, here's what will happen. I've got this Rublon icon here, which shows that the site is protected by Rublon, and I can go ahead and log in without any problem. The Rublon system verified my site, and I'm back into my Rublon secured WordPress website. So that's the whole process of how it works, basically. So as you can see, it's very easy to use. There's really no options or interface here. It really does what it promises to do, and in that it's invisible to the user. Some final thoughts about Rublon. In my opinion, it's a very handy security device. The reviews are really good. I've checked some reviews on the iTunes system, and there's really a lot of good feedback. And even on the WordPress.org plugin repository, we can see that there's a number of glowing reviews here. In fact, all the reviews are 5 stars, which is amazing for a new plugin. It's really something. The only thing is maybe that there aren't a lot of downloads, but considering that it was just released very recently in 2013, it's to be expected that there are not a lot of downloads. What we try to increase here at WPMare is the awareness that security is very, very important for your WordPress website. Let's not forget that earlier in 2013, there was a very bad brute force attack on WordPress websites, and there were a few thousand websites affected, in fact. And basically what happened was that the username and passwords was being guessed by the brute force attack. So in the cases where Rublon was installed, the hack would be useless, because even if you know the username and password, if your system, your device is not verified by Rublon, then you won't be able to log in. I also want to mention some other alternatives. There are alternatives, of course, to Rublon. One of the more popular ones is Authy. It's a plugin called Authy for WordPress. And what it does is the same two-step authentication process, but it works a bit different in that when you go to login, you get sent a code on your mobile device, usually via SMS or via Wi-Fi if you are connected to the net, and you have to enter that code. So it's the same two-step authentication. Why I prefer Rublon is that it's less hassle. You know, you don't have to download, you don't have to enter the code every time you log in. So with Rublon, you just secure your device, and whenever you log in, it's just a normal WordPress login, which does away with the hassle of having to enter an extra number and having to access your mobile device, which for a long might not be near you at the moment where you want to log in. So I really like Rublon, and I hope it get some traction in the WordPress community, and I highly recommend it for your security of your WordPress website. Thank you, and see you for the next one.